Hello everyone, welcome back to more. Now I've got mix and match saucer. Still got my same. It's too bad this is the last cup of this. Still got one of these for tomorrow. So palatable. Okay. And Japanese style cheesecake from Mango Mango, which means we'll see how Japanese style it is. I don't want to risk it freezing in case like they made it with some sort of specialty, this one in particular. I feel like this would freeze very well. And defrost into itself, but I couldn't help myself because it went with the last cup of pine beer so well. And this little bit of wine I had left. The level of how fresh the cake at the bottom is. As good as anything they've done. It's like, they just bake it to a consistency that like, if it was frozen, it's gonna be fine. If it goes to hell and it comes back, it's still gonna be okay. The only thing I'm like, ooh, woo, crying about right now the only thing I am literal crying about, the only thing I'm so crying about right now is, so, I'm sad that I don't have my ceremonial grade matcha here yet, because I would have loved to pour some on top of this. Little sprinkle. And then had something with it too. I just bought myself a small matcha kit. That came with this really, really convenient like caddy thing. That I kind of need stuff like that. Like, it's gonna make a really nice sort of like, well, I mean, it's like, I called it like sort of a TV tray, but I really only intend to use it for tea only. Can't wait, because I'm going to give myself that haircut, which is like pretty, you know, out there. And once it's that, I need deep healing. So I have 40 servings of ceremonial grade. but the ceremonial grade matcha comes much after the kit. It like arrives here much after. So I'm very patient about those things. I like have no issue with it. Sometimes I worry about whether something is like, you know, essentially lost somewhere and whether somebody would make themselves responsible for returning the funds to wherever they came. I'm always trying to figure that one out, but I'm never mad about, I don't know, I'm like, since it, sometimes I sort of depend on it, and I don't have a personal vehicle, and I've never really had my sort of an independence that, like, and, like, weird, like, it's not even independence, dude. I don't know what it is, honestly. Ooh, woo, so crying. So tomorrow, one of these cakes, that I bought, there's two of them. One of them is so cute. One of them is so cute that I'm dying. It is a slice of a Barbie cake. It's like, and then I get to have those fruit bowls mixed for breakfast, dude. It's the best. Amazing. Literally. There's like three different consistencies on there. Look what the bottom looks like. It's kind of like a piece of cake. It's so cute. Look. It's too bright, huh? Yes. Wish I had my matcha. I can't wait to get it. It's gonna be so nice to have it. A little bit less caffeine. Oh, up here, this is like cake. Interesting. I can't tell you what it is, but there's like three layers going on. And it's cheesecake in New York. Wine and beer, tea. Just kidding. I'm trying to be quiet because, like, you know, it's 10:30. And 35 ring. So yeah, tomorrow I had like leftover Irish tea and leftover goldenrod tea, and I mixed them. I mixed them together. And I put them away, and they have a little bit of my vegan creamer latte milk stuff that I've got, barista milk, and I'll put a little bit more of that on there tomorrow, and then I'll put some of the mint flavor, and that is what I will have with that slice of pink cake. That is literally immaculate. And that glass of wine. I guess I'll have both of them. And then, like, there's nobody in the world that's gonna stop me from doing that application. Even though my head feels like crap. Like. That was on purpose. I don't even want to remind myself. I guess I have a bald patch, but I got way too much hair covering it, and like, there's too many nice things going on to even, like, I won't even show you the graphic details. It would be cracking my skull on camera. Fucking horrible. It's one of the tastiest drinks I've ever had. I'm not gonna lie. I can't believe I made that myself. Again, not on purpose. That one was like straight up like, oh my god. Shot of estradiol. Messing me up, yo. Taking it. Just needing to take it. I kind of wish I had ovaries. Like, what do women with hysterectomies do after? Do they take estradiol? Or is that just like removing all? Maybe it's, I don't know. There's definitely a difference between one and getting your tubes tied or something. I don't know. I have no idea about those procedures. I just know about orchiectomies and. Trans-related SRS for making a like cavity to a woman's and then removing that. Honestly, Matt, it like interests me a lot to remove that, and because I just don't want to have to take these medications anymore, and I feel way better. Like, I have no context in the world. Like, and I used to be really depressed. Like, thing about this medication is that it was like, it's like the best depression medication I've ever taken. Like, I was like I used to be really, really depressed as a kid. And like a young teenager, and then. And then I got really fucking depressed. Like, it was like, I would get, like, depressed as a kid in Puerto Rico. I got depressed in California. Then I got depressed in Washington. And I remember in Washington, I was, like, taking vitamin D and passion flower, like, to save my fucking life at that point. An echinacea, or no. What else is it? St. John's wort. Just trying all sorts of like depression stuff. And then all of a sudden I started transitioning. And I wasn't good at it at first. Like, it definitely came off like this weird type of cross dressing, like. Person with like marginal access to money and like is it try to sort of up to, but the more it's got along, the only real disappointing thing is that like I'm in a region where I can't find medical professionals that will help, and now I have to move back to Portland, but I still feel too messed up in my head from having been hit in my head to go do Portland, which would probably involve being homeless, honestly, if I moved to Portland. No ties to anyone in Oregon except for like a friend in Portland area. Just, I don't know, but I lived in the Pacific Northwest by myself in Washington like that for years, and I didn't want to make ties, honestly, because I've suffered through stints of different, like, at any point, people were, like, inviting me to go to Hot Pot. in Chinatown and I lived in South Seattle. And it was embarrassing. I had to say no. Taking care of my ferret and taking care of all of the stuff on the link and everything had me anxious to a point that I was not socially, like, I wasn't able to carry out social situations, like, whatsoever. It was like, and then I had a really bad back pain that was very active and swollen. I mean, I still kind of, like, I'm even a day of just being, like, I can walk loads without my crutch. Like, I can just go and go for, like, the walk I've been wanting to get up to that I know would be a sacrifice. Like, the reason I haven't been up to it is because if I went up Oliver Street, all the way up to where the Bolt Company is, and there's like this great sunset that you can, like, go past these really old town houses that are really dope. If I went to go on my scenic walk, I'd crush my back. If I went to the Myanmar store and I did any of it wrong, and if I forgot to bring my carrying, like an old lady, like one of those things to carry groceries in the city, like, the sooner that you do all that stuff, the less likely you'll end up with a back like mine. And if you do nothing like what I or what people like I'm referring to do, then I don't know. Couple little brown crab apple seeds in there. I don't think that's good for me, but whatever. It's just because since they were so off on the tree, but they were fine. And they did the trick. Did you see all the head in that video? It just went like, it's so good. It tastes so good. That's one of the best drinks I've ever had, period. I'll be making that yearly. I'll be making a 5-gallon carboy of that pine beer with guava and brown crab apple. It's fucking amazing. I might regrow the crab apple, like, somewhere that, like, isn't, unless I find out that they don't spread it on. And this fox grape wine is just, like, immense. Like, wait till I get it down even better than this first batch. But it, like, super up the flavors that I want. Could use a little bit of cask, like oak or something, flavor. Could have probably used a bit more fortification and or that using a thermometer and using foil during pasteurization, which I didn't do. But I remember I had felt like, oh, I degassed it properly. So I was like less afraid of an explosion. And then that was first, and then the pine beer was kind of freaking me out. I was like, oh shit. I would hear something like an icicle falling, and I'd be like, oh. Bottle exploded, but I was like, had a bunch of bed sheets on top of it, so that the snow would fall on top of it and then insulate. Yeah, and then the rest of it is all like buried under logs and lots of things. Somewhere, buried treasure, secret buried treasure. But it won't be long until I dig it out. Based on how much alcohol it turned out to have, it just didn't have enough.